Okay, so in a perfect world, I need 10 playables this pack. It's a bit difficult to do, but my card quality is through the roof. I have many different cards that make tokens and two Sunblade Elf, so I'm gonna try to straddle the line and see if I can make a playable deck, and then afterwards decide if I'm gonna play green or red. Here, I'm just gonna take Mass Calcify. It's just a very good card. I have lots of good ways to stall the game with midnight guards, and I'm ultimately, no matter what two color combination I play, I'm always gonna have a reasonable number of white creatures and not very many creatures that die to it. So, in that sense, it'll be a plague win pretty often. Wow. A third Sunblade Elf, a Raise the Alarm, and a Sanctified Charge. I kind of feel like getting very greedy here and taking the Raise the Alarm because the other Sunblade Elf's just wheeled. I think that nobody at the table is green and white, so nobody will have a reason to take it. Yep, I'm gonna go max greed. I also think it's fine to just gamble when the draft's not going that well. Like, I clearly need playables, so I think I'm just gonna hope for the best on this one. Here I have Pillar of Light or Warden of the Beyond. Let me think. Normally, I would take Pillar, but given that I have a Paragon and a Mass Calcify, just having white creatures is extremely attractive. So, I think for that reason, I'm going to take Warden of the Beyond. Goodness, a fourth Raise the Alarm or a Hushwing Griff. There's a Warden of the Beyond and a Swiftclaw in this pack, but I have no interest in those. Given that I have two Sunblade Elf and a Paragon, those are huge reasons to want to have multiple token cards come from, like multiple tokens come from one card. Like if I can just flood the board with tokens, then I'll just play one of my cards that anthems, and that'll probably just win. So, take Raise the Alarm here. That is very late for an Aether Spouts. I think that card is extremely good. Also late for Stab Wound, and not a whole lot in this pack that I want to take and play. So I guess I'm left to just counter draft. I mean, I could take a second Wall of Essence, not that good. Tireless Missionaries is mediocre at best. I guess I'll just take the Tireless Missionaries because my card quality is high, but my number of playables is low, and if I'm desperate, it's an excusable card to put in your deck. It is inefficient, but it's better than just not having a card to put to play, you know? Here, I will take Dauntless River Marshal as a 2/1 for 2 with no words on it. Paragon of Eternal Wilds, Meteorite, or Divine Favor? Think I'll take Divine Favor because it allows me to play the Heliod's Pilgrim, which currently has no things to get. So I'll take that. Congregate or Bronze Sable? I'm gonna take Bronze Sable, and next pick is where I will see if I get the Sunblade Elf back. Let's see. Wow. Unlucky for me, but I only wheeled two of them, so that's still pretty good. Here, I will take Tyrant's Machine. And Moss Beast is all right. Not gonna play any of these. Well, my deck is quite good, but it's just low on playables. Could see myself just playing 18 lands to not have to deal with putting really bad cards in my deck. Wonder what I could have done differently. I went white from the start and I took all the best white cards, and I have great white cards, but ultimately I just ended up, you know, short on playables. Red didn't seem particularly open. Green didn't seem particularly open. I mean, I took good red and green cards, I just didn't see anything after that. I suppose black looked open, but black white is not really where you want to be. I'm definitely suffering from having taken Plummet over Wall of Mulch. Not like Wall of Mulch would be a great card in my deck or anything. It's clearly not that good, but I would way rather have a card that just has cycling than one of the cards that I'm going to end up playing. Getting four Raise the Alarm is pretty nice. And with two Sunblade Elf and a Paragon, I'll probably just get really good draws. What to do with this lack of playable situation, though? I could play Tyrant's Machine, Wall of Essence. I guess I could main deck a Naturalizer of Plummet. That's not usually my favorite thing to do. I could just play three colors. I could play 10 Plains, 4 or 5 Forest, and like 2 Mountains, and play Lightning Strike. That doesn't sound too bad, actually. In that sense, I could play the Lightning Strike and maybe the Inferno Fist and play 18 lands and have my mana be 10, 5, 3. Inferno Fist obviously is not a card you want to splash, but given that I have a Heliod's Pilgrim, it's passable. It's going to be hilarious getting draws where I have Dauntless River Marshal, which requires blue mana that I don't have, and then also having green, red, and white in my deck. Yeah, I mean, desperate times do call for desperate measures, and given that I have two Sunblade Elf, those are pretty good mana sinks, so if I get mana floated, it's not really the end of the world. Yeah, I don't hate the look of that. I think 10 planes is plenty. I only really want to draw one. 18 lands is admittedly it's high for this deck, but not sure exactly what I could play instead, and it's hard to make a playable mana base and not make some sacrifices. It's not clear to me that my deck would be better if I cut a land for a Carnivorous Moss Beast or something like that. Part of me thinks that my card quality is so high that as long as I don't get mana screwed, I'll have a good chance to win any game that I play, but that could be incorrect. Alright, I'll just accept the fact that I'm going to get mana flooded some number of games.